Hello, Vinyl community. How you doing? It's Bill with the Vinylverse. This is a video I've been wanting to make for a long, long time. I recently saw that there's been a thread going around of show your vinyl box sets. So I've wanted for a long time to show my box sets in general. Just about all of them are on CD. Actually, everything I'm going to show here is on CD. So I know the thread is show your vinyl box sets, but I only really have a couple, so, and I've shown them before, so I didn't want to revisit them here. But I wanted to show everything that I've had kind of packed away and show my CD box sets. I'm going to leave some out, so here is the Beatles. That's the Beatles Complete Stereo Recordings box set. I'm not going to show that. And I have a bunch of Genesis, box sets here. You see them? I'm not going to show them in this video. But I have a lot of box sets here that I want to get through. So I'm going to breeze through a bunch of these, but try to show you them the best I can and quick as I can. So the 90s was really when I was buying a lot of box sets, and I was looking at the dates of a lot of these, and most of them fall into like 1991 through maybe 1998 or so, and with the exception of the odd one here or there that might be a little bit later. So to get started is Ella, the legendary Decca Recordings. So Ella Fitzgerald, great box set here. Except it has a kind of a poor design there. It's very, very difficult to read. You see that kind of orange writing on the gold background there. This was the sheet inside of the shrink wrap on the back of the box set. Comes with a real nice book here. There's Ella. So yeah, really great box set. Four CD. I already forget what year this came out. I think this one was a little bit later. Let's see if I can find the date real fast. Maybe 1998. I can't really see it. It's tough to read. But yeah, great box set, Ella Fitzgerald. Very cool box set here, the legendary Decca Recordings. Next from, I don't know, maybe 1994, somewhere around there, maybe even earlier, David Bowie, Sound and Vision. It's the cover. Not too much to this box set, but it, you know, it has four discs here. Very, very cool. Each one of these has a little insert. So this box set has a lot of like outtakes and demos or previously unreleased, rare singles, some live versions, I believe. Yeah. So very cool. David Bowie, Sound and Vision. Next, from 1988, I think. Eric Clapton, Crossroads. I believe this was one of the first box sets to come out. I remember Bob Dylan. It was like Bob Dylan, Rod Stewart, Eric Clapton, Jethro Tull. They were like the first four that I remember ever seeing in box set form. Comes with a insert here of Songwriters and Publishers Index. Nice book. And then the four CDs here. And the CDs are don't really have much going on as far as liner notes or anything like that. It's pretty plain, just writing credits. So this covers his whole career pretty much up until that point. Like this disc one has the R-Birds, John Mayall, John Mayall's Blues Breakers, Cream, and then it goes all the way up to disc four, which what was the name of that album? Beyond the Sun, something like that. It has, or was it August? It has She's Waiting. Yeah, so it's a pretty complete coverage of his career up to that point. Next, this is Listen to the Band, The Monkees. This is 1991. There's the back. It's a pretty complete representation of their entire catalog. I don't believe it has many rarities or anything like that. Just straight up true Monkees recordings. Nice book here. And then the four discs. Yeah, very cool. Very cool box set. Actually, I believe, if I'm not mistaken, this may have been the first box set that I ever bought. Can't really remember. Maybe the Crossroads, Eric Clapton Crossroads was the first. But this was one of the earliest ones that I bought. Next is The Essential King Crimson, Frame by Frame. This came out in 1991 also. And I will say that most of these, I bought them as they were released. This comes with a nice book as well. Mr. Fripp. Oh, there's Red. Mid-70s. So really a thorough book. Really great. And it also comes with a King Crimson family tree here. Pretty cool. And then it has four discs. And the, you know, they kind of make an image there, I think. So yeah, this covers that, their whole career up until that point. Pretty great box set. And then next I have Yes Years. This came out in 1991 also. So this has a bunch of like unreleased sessions, BBC sessions, previous unreleased songs, unreleased live version. So live versions, preview song, release. So a lot of like unreleased stuff on here. So this nice book here. Stuff, and then the back, if I remember, this kind of folds open for the Yes family tree. Which way does it go? This way. So that's pretty cool. And then the four CDs here. Just the back of one. This is a great box set. So those are the box sets I have in this style, this kind of flat record size box set. Then I have a bunch in kind of like this book format. Here's another Yes box set. This is Yes, The Word Is Live. So these are all live recordings of Yes from 1970 through 1988, it looks like. This is three discs. There's two discs there and the fourth disc there. Beautiful artwork by Roger Dean. Booklet attached inside. Yeah, and this came out in 2003. Another great box set. Then I have The Police, Message in a Box, The Complete Police Recordings, 1993. So this is pretty much the entire Police catalog. All in one set here on four discs. Again, with a book glued inside. Pretty cool. These are in no particular order. I kind of just laid them out and shown them as I have them laid out here. Next, John Denver, the Country Roads Collection. This came out in, I don't know what year this came out in, I can't read it. That's the back. But this is this is all, I believe, just like studio recordings of John Denver, kind of like a anthology type. Four discs. Just the first two and the last two. And then the book glued inside again. This is a wonderful box set. Really good. Then, this is the Moody Blues Time Traveler, and this came out in 1994, I think. This is like a complete anthology for the movie Moody Blues. It includes a bonus disc of live recordings. So this is five discs. Yeah. This is four discs with a bonus disc of live recordings. And again, with the booklet style in here. Cool. And the bonus disc is kind of in this little sleeve here of the live recordings. So that's cool. And then I will show my two of my Genesis box sets, the Genesis Archive 1967-75 and Genesis Archive number 2, 1976-1992. This is 67-75. I don't remember what year this came out. Is it 1998? Yeah, 1998. Again, four disc. And this actually has a book that comes, slides out of it. So this is a very cool box set. It has a complete live recording of The Lamb Lies Down on Broadway, as well as a complete recording of live recording of what year was it? Genesis Live in 74, I believe. And then it has a lot of early demos and unreleased songs from before their first album, From Genesis to Revelation. Okay, and then Genesis Archive number 2, 1976-1992. This contains a lot of B-sides. Disc 2 is all live material. And Disc 3 has like 12-inch releases, some live recordings, and then other EP stuff. So same as the Archive 1, it's got the discs there, and it has the slide-out book. So, pretty cool. This came out in 2000, I believe. So that's Genesis Archive number 2, 1976-1992. And then one more in that style of box set, and it's Impulse 30-year celebration. This is just two discs here with a nice book. And this is just a compilation of artists that have recorded on the Impulse label. So, like Sonny Rollins, Count Basie, who you see there, John Coltrane, Duke Ellington, Archie Shepp, Sonny Rollins, Pharoah Sanders there, Chico Hamilton, Shirley Scott. Ben Webster there. So this is a pretty cool compilation here in a nice little package. Next, I have some box sets in kind of this style, and this is the Doors box set. This has a lot of demos, a lot of live material. Yeah, a lot of demos. Well, disc one is a lot of demos. Disc two is a 1970 concert live in New York, so recorded at Madison Square Garden. Disc three is a bunch of live recordings and demos again. And disc four is called Band Favorites, and it's songs picked by John Densmore, Robbie Krieger, and Ray Manzarek. So this came out in 1997, I think. Comes with this book. So very cool. Oh, the inside of the box kind of has this, I don't know, psychedelic stuff going on. And here's the discs. So it's disc 4, Band Favorites. So the doors, box set. And here's a really great one. This is Jefferson Airplane Loves You. Three compact discs. This has previous unreleased stuff. It has some unreleased live recordings from Woodstock. Really cool box set. This came out in 1992. Here's the book. And the discs. Sign. Yeah. There's the third disc. So a very cool box set by Jefferson Airplane. Then I have the Beach Boys, Good Vibrations, and this came out in 1993. It looks like. Here's the book. This is a five CD box set. It says the ultimate compilation spanning their full career from the home demo of Surfin' USA to the number one hit Kokomo. Over 120 songs on four CDs, including many never before released selections and rare finds. Plus a bonus CD featuring live tracks and special collector's session material. So here's the book. That's the Beach Boys. Good Vibrations. They all have cool artwork on the CDs. And here is that Sessions bonus CD here. Other two. So that's the Beach Boys. Good Vibrations, 30 years of the Beach Boys. And then one of my favorite box sets is the Beach Boys, the Pet Sounds Sessions. This came out in 1996. This has, on disc number one, it has the stereo mix of Pet Sounds, but then it has a bunch of the sessions from the Pet Sounds Sessions. Disc number two is more of the Pet Sounds Sessions. Disc number three has vocal only tracks, which is really, really cool. Hearing just their voices. and all those great harmonies. And it also has alternate versions of the Pet Sounds tracks. And then there's a bonus disc of the original mono mix, which was remastered in 1996. And it actually had this mailer here to looks like a survey, Beach Boys survey type thing. Of course it has a book. Great stuff there. It has another very detailed book here of the sessions. There's Carol Kay, the great bassist from the Wrecking Crew. And here is that mono mix, remastered mono mix that is kind of in this little mini LP sleeve. And everything else is in this. Everything else is in here. Okay, we're almost there. Then I have a couple box sets in this style, kind of this box. And the first one is the John Lennon Anthology here. And this came out in 1998. Very cool box set. And everything's laid out in there like this. So this is a great box set that kind of covers Lennon's whole solo career. They each have unique artwork by him on them, on the CDs here. It's a pretty nice package. It also comes with a book. Interior there, it says book. And it kind of slides out here. A lot of information in here. So there's that. And the other one I have in that style, other than the Genesis ones, wherever, up there somewhere, Creedence Clearwater Revival. This came out in 2001. And this is pretty much every recording by Creedence, including, so it says here, it's all here in the Creedence box. Six discs with every CCR recording in remastered 20-bit K2 super coding, including live material, and a full disc devoted to their rarely heard apprenticeship as the Blue Velvets and Gollywogs, which feature 9 previously unreleased tracks. So that's the box here. 6 CDs and a book. This is a terrific box set. And like it said, it pretty much has everything ever released by CCR. See here, disc one, it says Tom Fogerty and the Blue Velvets and the Gollywogs. So that is pre-Creedence Clearwater Revival there. And then disc two is 1967 and 1969. So great stuff. Disc 3 is more 1969. Disc 4 is 1970. Disc 5 is 1970 studio and live, and then 1972. And disc 6 is 1970 to 1971 live. So there's that. Almost there. Two more things. Then I have a couple box sets in kind of this style here. First is Coltrane, the complete 1961 Village Vanguard recordings. I don't remember what year this came out. I want to say the mid-90s, but I'm not positive. It comes with a cool poster. And then a book. Let's see if I can find a date on this. And then each one of the discs has and they open up. Okay, and then last but not least, this is a cool box set, and it is Miles Davis, Gil Evans, the complete Columbia studio recordings. So it has the six studio recordings that Miles Davis and Gil Evans put out, kind of in this book form here. So it starts off with a booklet, and then it gets into the actual CDs. So there's Miles Ahead, and it has a little some documentation on that, those recordings. Porgy and Bess, Sketches of Spain, Quiet Nights. Miles Davis plus 19. And then the last disc, it's alternate and rehearsal takes. So disc 6, and it has some information about those here. So very cool set here. And this, I don't remember what year it came out. And that is most of my CD box set collection here. So I dug everything out of the basement to do this and show everybody what I have here. And someday I'll probably get to the Genesis boxes up there. But I know this was a long video, so I appreciate you sitting through it and watching and checking out what CD box sets I have here. So thank you very much. And I really appreciate it. I hope you're all doing well. If you didn't know, I am running a contest right now to celebrate my 2-year anniversary in the VC. Plus, when I hit my 700 subscriber milestone, I thought it was a good time to have a contest. So there's It runs through April 10th, so if you want to jump in, please do so. Plenty of time still to get in. Appreciate everyone who's already entered. It's been great watching those videos. Information to that contest is down on my channel. Should be easy to find the video for that. So please jump in and make a response if you wish to get in on the contest. And that's going to do it for me. This video has gone on way too long, right? So thank you everyone for watching. I hope you liked seeing these box sets. Now that I have a CD player that I thrifted, I'll be playing some of these and listening to them. So everyone take care. Thanks so much for watching. Hope you're all doing well. Hope you're all staying healthy, washing your hands. So I will talk to you all again soon. Take care now. Bye.